A West Michigan native who covered the debate over Don't Ask, Don't Tell from the White House is speaking right now in her hometown.
First, she spoke with 24-Hour News 8's Tony Taliavia about the debate and about the ongoing gay rights controversy in Holland. Tony joins us live in studio.
Brian and Sue, Carrie Elleveld says the Don't Ask, Don't Tell debate taught her that individuals can often be more effective at making change than politicians or even activist groups. The East Grand Rapids High School grad covered the White House for The Advocate, a news organization covering issues affecting the lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender, or LGBT, community. Elleveld told us that she feels the next frontier in the debate over gay rights is employment discrimination. That's been part of the debate in Holland over a proposal to add sexual orientation to the city's anti-discrimination ordinance for housing and employment. Backers say it's about basic fairness. Some critics argue it legally sanctions immoral activities. Back to Don't Ask, Don't Tell, we asked Elleveld to share something from inside the debate that she thought many of us outside Washington did not see.
One of the more interesting things is how hard President Obama campaigned on Don't Ask, Don't Tell. He was in front of mainstream audiences talking up repeal. But once you get into the White House, you're part of the government, and the government's part of the establishment. And so, you know, what you go to do, what you say you're going to do on the campaign trail, isn't what your priorities always are once you get in.
She says she became an advocate for the successful repeal by virtue of asking about gay and lesbian issues when they weren't at the front of the agenda. Elleveld is in town to speak. The event started at 6. It's not free. It's a fundraiser for the Progressive Women's Alliance. The group raises money to help progressive political candidates.